Government has proposed a fine of 10 million shillings for any teacher found teaching without a valid license. This measure is part of the National Teachers Bill 2024 that has been tabled before Parliament by State Minister for Higher Education, Dr. John Muyingo. The National Teachers Bill aims to establish a professional body to regulate the teaching profession by consolidating registration and licensing processes and providing for discipline, professional conduct, and ongoing development within the field. Under the proposed bill, all teachers would be required to obtain a license valid for 4 years.
Right on, I will speak this afternoon. I'm presenting the National Teachers Bill to Parliament. And when you read through this bill, many of the issues that are being raised now are going to be addressed.
The bill also proposes a fine of 5 million shillings for those who obtain teaching license through fraudulent means. Deputy Speaker Thomas Tayebwa has referred the bill to Parliament's Committee on Education and Sports for further scrutiny.
I think it would be good that as the House and their country at large, we get to have an assessment of this policy. Sometime down the road, is there a value for this, which government was insisting on, to say that the science teachers are way better than the arts teachers, because it demoralized the arts teachers. They are being seen as non-entities, and yet they also contribute to this country.
Attorney General Chiriowa Chiwanuka has requested that Parliament allowed executive time for consultations to develop a legal instrument that will allow medical interns who have not been deployed to be permitted to cover their own expenses. This followed a statement by State Minister for Health Anifa Kawoya, who gave a brief about the delayed deployment of medical interns.
We have got part of the answer is those who are ready. That's an easy win. That's a quick win. So as an executive, we need to just go back and make a policy which allows those who are ready to meet their own cost to do it, I think.
Kawoya said that the failure by the ministry to deploy hundreds of medics was due to insufficient funds. She said the 35.6 billion shillings that was allocated was only enough to deploy 1,500 medical interns from the 2023 cohort and the previous years, as well as the government-sponsored pharmacist for the 2024 cohort. Kawoya requested an additional 18.8 billion shillings to be able to meet the shortfall.
Given out the constraints that is facing deployment of the interns, the way forward, number one, we think as a ministry, the urgent need to prioritize internship training and allocate adequate funding based on numbers enrolled into the universities and communicated to the councils following completion of training.
The two, Deputy Speaker Thomas Tayebwa, however, questioned why the government does not give go-ahead to interns who are able to meet their own expenses.
Because personally, I've been paying for some of these students, okay? And the students have come, and I'm ready to pay their allowances, like how I've been paying their fees. I'm ready. They have completed the course. They don't want your allowance even, okay? What they want is to qualify so that they go and take up other opportunities.
With reported cases of exploitation by senior lawyers, including hiring them without contracts, not providing them with transport assistance in addition to sexual harassment, freshly enrolled lawyers have established an association to fight for their plight. Dubbed the Young Lawyers Network, Tony Tumukunde, one of the brains behind the association, said its purpose is to advocate for good working conditions for young lawyers who he said are being exploited by the senior lawyers.
Why are we here today with our colleagues? We have felt the pinch the young lawyers all in Uganda and outside Uganda are feeling after graduating from law school and graduating from the Law Development Center. A young lawyer is a person that has practiced for 1 to 5 years according to the description of the Uganda Law Society.
Lawyer Rachel Ayebare said that many young female lawyers are being sexually exploited for jobs, and that is why they are demanding contracts.
95% of the female lawyers was alerted when they were coming out in media about the badisanga. In fact, abamu wafuna olubuto chikoma kwecho. Most of the young girls are not being paid for what they can bring to the table. They are being paid with their bodies. So it's one thing to be beautiful and it's another thing to have the brains. In the profession, they don't consider it. In most, I'm not saying that every chiri everyone.
The young lawyers also called upon the government to set up a wage bill for their profession, as it is the case in Kenya and Tanzania. They also want the judiciary jobs reserved for them, such as magistrate grade 1, saying it defeats logic to allow lawyers of over 20 years' experience to also apply for such jobs.